People have given me a hearing without legal representation or anything.
Did you shoot the president?
I didn't shoot anybody, no, sir.
You just heard Oswald, who said he did not shoot anybody. I'm being pummeled here. Being pummeled very heavily.
I didn't shoot anybody, sir. I haven't been told what I'm here for.
Do you have a lawyer?
No, sir, I don't.
Charged with the murder of President Kennedy as he is led from the police headquarters in Dallas, perhaps being transferred now to the county jail. Let's switch down there and see if we can pick up word of
jail office here, and will now be taken to the police show-up room. Our cameras are being moved there now. Dolly it out.
He's being moved down to the basement assembly room.
Keep moving. Stay back.
He'll be taken down to the basement assembly room, where he will confront the assembly of press gathered here at the police station for the past 10 hours or so of interrogation.
Positively know nothing about this situation here. Well, I was questioned by a judge. However, I protested at that time that I was not allowed legal representation. But during that very short and sweet hearing, I really don't know what the situation is about. Nobody has told me anything except that I'm accused of murdering a policeman. I know nothing more than that, and I do request someone to come forward to give me a legal assistance.
Did you kill the president?
No, I've not been charged with that. In fact, nobody has said that to me yet. The first thing I heard about it was when the newspaper reporters in the hall asked me that question.
You have been.
Nobody said what?
Sir?
You have been.
Nobody said what?
Okay, man.
Okay.
What did you do in Russia?
A policeman hit me.
That was Oswald. Lee Oswald, who was charged with the murder of the president of the United States.
Less than 2 hours after the president was shot, less than 1 hour after a Dallas policeman was shot and killed in the downtown area. Oswald first was charged with killing the policeman. Officers say they have an eyewitness to that shooting. After further questioning, he was formally charged with the president's death. Oswald has admitted nothing.
Here comes Oswald down the hall again.
You fire that rifle.
Best dispatches you people have been given, but I emphatically deny these charges.
Oswald has hustled through a doorway. He says he has nothing against anybody. He has not committed any act of violence. Oswald makes this claim as he's hustled from the interrogation room through a doorway down an elevator, up an elevator into his jail cell.
Legal representation. These police officers have not allowed me to have any. I don't know what this is all about.
I killed the president.
No, sir, I didn't. People
how'd you get the black guy?
Sir?
You shoot the president?
I work in that building.
Were you in the building at the time?
Naturally, if I work in that building, yes, sir.
Back up, man.
Did you shoot the president?
No, they're taking me in because of the fact that I live in Missouri.
What time did you leave?
I'm just a patsy.
Did you shoot the president?
And here comes Lee Harvey Oswald. His back is to you. You can't quite see him. His face is still...
basic fundamental hygienic rights, I mean, like the shower and the book.
Before he's pushed into a door for questioning, he said he would like certain basic fundamental rights, including the right to take a shower. Now, of course, we don't know if he's deprived of this privilege that he calls a right. Do you mind if we shout a question at him without stopping him?
No question, right. Him, no
all
way.
Right. No question right. At all.
The more you upset him, the more difficult it is for us
all
to
right.
Talk to
we want to do. We want to do whatever you want us to do. So if you say no question.
If you go beyond the door.
What's that?
Back up as far as you can against that wall.
It makes I want you right. To can we call that the second part of the interrogation?
No.
Don't want you calling out nothing.
Let's make it clear we have all agreed with the chief that we will not ask Oswald any questions.
We want to cooperate with you, gentlemen, every way in the world that you can. But if we have to, we may have to ask you to get back beyond this door and stay.
Here is Lee Oswald, the ex-Marine accused of killing President Kennedy.
We interrupt the proceedings of the White House to go to the Dallas jail. Let's report the health of men there.
Oswald's face is rather badly bruised. Police explained yesterday that there was a sharp scuffle when he was arrested in the Dallas theater.
Reporters back away from
there were no questions put to Oswald by reporters. We agreed at the request of the chief of police that we would make no effort to question him here this morning.
He could say it. However, as you saw, Oswald went by and had nothing to say. He's gone into the homicide bureau.
Full name is Lee Harvey Oswald, OSWALD.
I really don't know what the situation is about. Nobody has told me anything except that I'm accused of murdering a police officer. I know nothing more than that, and I do request for someone to come forward to give me a legal assistance.
Did you kill the president?
No, I have not been charged with that. In fact, nobody has said that to me yet. The first thing I heard about was when the newspaper reporters in the hall asked me that question.
You have been.
Nobody said what?
Sir?
You have been.
Nobody said what?
Okay, we ain't here. Okay.
What did you do in Russia?
A policeman hit me.
Here comes Oswald down the hall again.
You buy that rifle.
I don't know what dispatches you people have been given, but I emphatically deny these charges.
Oswald has hustled through a doorway.
He hasn't admitted killing the president to anyone.
You have any reason to believe that there's any organization behind it?
How is it he says there's nothing mentioned to it?
Well, I don't know what he said. He says he didn't do it. We're still working on the evidence. This has been a joint effort by the Secret Service, the Federal Bureau of Investigation, the Dallas Police Department, the Dallas Sheriff's Office, my office, and Captain Will Fritz has been in charge of it.
How would you describe his mood during the questioning?
Has very been... arrogant. Mm-hmm. Has been all along.
What do you still say, Chief?
He just denies everything. Mm-hmm.
How do you sum him up as a man, based on your experience with criminal types?
Oh, I think it's a man that planned this murder weeks or months ago and has laid his plans carefully and carried them out and has planned at that time what he's going to tell the police that are questioning him at present.
What was his motive?
He didn't give any motive since he denies them both.
As we understand it, no one actually saw this man pull the trigger of the rifle that apparently killed the president. Is that correct?
That is correct up to this time in our investigation.
What about ballistic test, Chief?
The ballistic test, we haven't had a final report, but it is, I understand, will be favorable.
Do you think the smudged fingerprints that have been found on the rifle which killed the president will be able to establish the identity of the killer?
We hope so, but I couldn't say positive at this time that they will be.
Well, you enough to convict him?
I don't know whether it would be enough to convict him or not if we can put his
prints on the rifle, or it certainly would connect him with the rifle.
We want to say this, that this investigation has been carried on jointly by the FBI, the Secret Service, the Rangers, and the Dallas Police Department. Captain Fritz has been in charge.
Has he made any admissions at all about the shooting of the police officer?
No, nothing. He denies everything.
I would say that without any doubt, he's the killer. The law says beyond a reasonable doubt and to a moral certainty, which there's no question that he was the killer of President Kennedy.
And will you ask death in the electric chair for Lee Oswald?
Yes, sir. We'll ask the death penalty.
How many cases of this type have you been involved in? That is, when the death penalty is involved.
Since I've been district attorney, I've asked death penalty in 24 cases.
And how many times have you attained it?
23.
This man's apparent subversive background, was there any surveillance? Were police aware of his presence in Dallas?
We and the police department here did not know he was in Dallas. I understand the FBI did know that he was in Dallas.
Chief, it's not normally our practice for the FBI to inform the police.
Yes.
Police Chief, do you have...
We did not have...
But you were not informed.
We had not been informed of this man.
Chief, do you have any concern for the safety of your prisoner in view of the high feeling among the people of Dallas over the assassination of the president?
No, but precautions necessary. Precautions will be taken, of course.
Chief, we understand you have the results of the paraffin test which were made to determine whether Oswald had fired a weapon. Can you tell us what those tests
showed? I understand that it was positive.
What does that mean?
It only means that he fired a gun.
What about the paraffin test?
Yes, I haven't gone into that. The paraffin test showed that he had recently fired a gun. It was on both hands.
Both hands?
Both hands.
Recently fired a
gun. A gun.
Gordon Shanklin, the FBI agent in charge at Dallas, added, quote, a paraffin test used to determine whether a person has fired a weapon recently was administered to Oswald shortly after he was apprehended Friday. 1 hour after the assassination. It showed that particles of gunpowder from a weapon, probably a rifle, remained on Oswald's cheek and hands. Close quote. The test, however, showed no gunpowder on either hands or cheek, and no nitrates on Oswald's face. Confronted with but one possible interpretation, that the paraffin test results were consistent with innocence, the commission concluded that the test, formally presented as a cornerstone of the case against Oswald, was, quote, completely unreliable.